Welcome to another edition of Bedtime Stories with Grandpa Jubal. In today's episode, we're going to be talking about productivity apps. Now, a lot of people have asked me about the specific apps that I use to be productive. I'm going to show you the apps I use. I'm going to show you how I use them. But I also want to emphasize upfront that the actual apps you use are less important than the way you use the apps. But I'm going to show you both. So first, let's start with my task list manager. I use Things 3. Things 3 is, I think it's only for iOS and macOS. And I've been using this since medical school. The thing I like about it, it's an upfront fee. I mean, it's kind of expensive. It's like $50 for just the Mac app, but you pay it once and you're done. And it's super clean, it works seamlessly, it really just makes sense. So this is my today page, and you know, things that are on my calendar automatically show up on the top. I'm actually in Salt Lake City right now, I'm gonna be riding 100 miles on a bike for the first time, my first ever century. And then I have, the way it's organized is like a today view. So this is the default view and you see what you're supposed to do today. So I'm already falling behind. I didn't do my newsletter, which was supposed to go out yesterday. I have some other things that I need to be doing. And this is much more effective than I think just having a list of all these items you need to do without any sort of hierarchy or due date sort of thing. So you can actually use the inbox when you just want to dump ideas. I really like that. You can quickly open up the app, just dump random things. I mean, it's at 33 right now. You're supposed to clear it out and organize it, which I need to do. But right now it's a lot of books I need to download or documentaries I want to download or, you know, things like that. And then you can actually categorize tasks. Sometimes you don't want to have a due date. You may just have some tasks that, like these ones, you know, if I go to self-development, you'll see this two-year journaling exercise. But you can also just have tasks that don't have a due date and they will just always live there until you want to go take care of that little project. So under personal, I have, you know, my daily habits. I have groceries, that's my grocery list. Self-development, things like this, journaling exercise. And then Medical Insiders, obviously there's a lot because it's not just the YouTube, but also the courses that we're doing, the merch, the services, the website, all that stuff. And then video topics. So when you guys send me video suggestions, and if I like them and I want to do a video on that in the future, I don't want to forget. So I write it all down here under video topics. And as that list grows, I have a, you know, anytime I want to create a new video, I'll just go there and see what inspires me in that moment. Mem, of course. We don't actually use, we use Asana for Mem because Things 3 is only for an individual, not for a team. So there isn't that much under Mem. And then I was gonna do a podcast, which is on hold, and then Blue Link, which is the first like entrepreneurial project, first serious entrepreneurial project that I pursued. So that's my to-do list manager. I don't think the actual app you use is as important as how you use it. And for most people, I think it's beneficial to review your to-do list manager and kind of clean it up once a week. So every Sunday evening for me, so my today list will be overrun with more than just four items and I'll clean it up. I'll either delegate tasks to other people or I'll reschedule it for some point in the future, or I'll just delete it and reassess whether or not that task needs to actually get done. All right, next, let's talk about the ways that I actually take notes. So I take notes across several different apps. It seems very confusing and very much not ideal, but this really does work for me. So the first app, the default app is Notes, the Notes app that comes with your iPhone and your Mac, and it syncs seamlessly. The reason I use this as my default kind of just like dump is because it's super quick. So these other apps I'm gonna show you afterwards, they're great, but they usually take 5 seconds to load up and then they're not as quick and snappy and as just using notes. So for example, if I am listening to a podcast, some podcasts I do take notes, some others I don't, I will open up this Notes app and have a podcast note here for all the notes I wanna take. And it's just way quicker than going directly into Evernote or into Notion to actually put the notes there. These are notes that are not really needing a specific place that need to be referenced. This is kind of like my working list. So, you know, the other day I was cycling around Red Rock here in Las Vegas, and I came across a group of cyclists and I was asking them about good trails and other, you know, recommendations for bike shops. So I took notes on that, you know, right then and there quickly on my phone. Same with restaurants I want to try, or, you know, my car, I'm going to go track it. So I was doing some research on what parts I need to buy. So these are not things that I really need to reference in the future. I just want to know it once, get it taken care of, and then I can just delete the note. Or things like podcast notes, I can then reorganize them to someplace else. And that someplace else is, of course, Notion. So I used to use Evernote for all of my podcast notes. And when we get to Evernote, I'll explain to you why I no longer use it that much. But Notion I've been very happy with. And I use it both for personal and also for my business. So this is my personal Notion. I haven't used it that extensively, but right now I'm using it primarily for my podcast notes. And you know, I've actually listened to every single Tim Ferriss podcast episode from one to the current one, which is like 431. For a lot of them, not all of them, but for most of them, or maybe like half of them, I take notes. And, you know, some of the notes are going to be more extensive. You know, I feel like this one, yeah, is, you know, a little more detailed. And there's no real formula here. It kind of just depends on what I feel like doing. So for some podcast episodes, I will take more notes, like this one, for example. This is, you know, longer notes than normal. And then other ones are going to be pretty short, like this one with Brian Koppelman. Now for how I use Notion with Med School Insiders. Notion is like the brain of Med School Insiders. Everything that we do in some way or another is connected here, whether it's the blog and how we keep track of what blog posts that we're working on, or whether it's the YouTube videos like over here. These are all the videos I've done. And, you know, under any given one of these, we'll actually have a script. So for example, like the discipline video, I will actually have research and notes. I guess this video I didn't need to do any research, but you know, I'll have a script. I'll actually have the script that I read off of verbatim for my videos. And I work with my editor. We both have shared access here, and you know, there's a checklist. I actually got the inspiration for creating this template through Thomas Frank's videos on Notion. So that was super helpful. In fact, his is much more thorough than what I have. Mine's kind of simple because I don't have B-roll and stuff, at least not on the Med School Insider channel. So definitely check out his video if you want more details on how you can make the most of this for a video production standpoint. We use Notion for a lot of other things, you know, the instructions for how to handle various things, all of our SOPs. So when we have this situation in the business or that situation or an unhappy customer, what do we actually do to resolve the situation? Everything is in Notion and we can quickly reference that just to standardize things, make it, again, systems, right? Next up, Evernote. I no longer use Evernote all that much. It was my go-to app for just about everything I took notes on back when I was in medical school. I started using Evernote back in 2012 and I still have literally all of my med school notes in here. Yeah, so like pulmonology, I remember I did, I would have the actual slides that I would take notes on briefly and then save the PDF here, but I would create these summary sheets, which I talked about on the Med School Insider channel, how I would take notes, and I would scan them because I wanted everything to be digital. And I still very much try to make everything digital so I don't have to organize files. I can just search for them. And the cool thing about Evernote is it has OCR. So I could actually search for, you know, total ventilation, and assuming my handwriting didn't suck too bad, then it would be able to search for that and show me this note that says total ventilation, for example. But I use it for a lot of other things. For example, my car. This is probably one of the nerdiest things about me. I mean, there's many nerdy things about me. I keep a list of all the cars that I've ever driven. A lot of, I mean, even the boring like Toyota Camrys, and the automatic list isn't that exciting. The manual list is more exciting, but it just, I used Evernote for just about everything. And I've even used it recently. Like I drove a Lotus Evora 400 back in February of 2020. But over the years, I started having more and more frustrations with Evernote because it felt kind of clunky and there was issues with formatting that I thought they would fix with time, and they never really did. The other thing is I put all my recipes here. So when I'm cooking, I'll have my phone on the kitchen counter, and if the phone goes to sleep and I unlock it, it won't go back to the actual recipe. It'll go back to the Evernote homepage and have to search for the recipe again. And then like all these small things would just make it less pleasant to use Evernote. And it's clunky on the computer. And you know, I got an iPad in residency and I was taking notes, but it wouldn't, the writing wouldn't be in line with the actual notes I was typing. So for a lot of reasons, I just got less enamored with Evernote as an app. So I still kind of use it from time to time. I still use it for recipes. I still put occasional things in here. But for the most part, I'm actually trying to transition most of these things toward Notion because I think that's a better fit for my use case. And last, let's talk about Bear. This is a writing app that I use exclusively to write Med School Insider scripts. I don't use it for anything else. All my Kevin Jabal MD, I don't really script these videos, but I do sometimes take notes and I kind of plan them out. That all goes into Notion. I use Bear exclusively for writing Med School Insider scripts, but I don't really save them here, or I don't really try to organize them too much because I want to have everything in just one spot, which would be Notion. But just writing in Bear is a joy. I love that, you know, late at night or if I'm on a plane, I can have this theme, which is black background and then white and yellow text, which to me is a lot easier to view in the dark. I'm definitely not using Bear to its full potential, but for this use case, I'm pretty happy with it. All right, the last app is this email client called Front. It's an email software that's designed for teams. So essentially having shared inboxes, things like that. So what it allows me to do with my team is, for example, my assistant can view incoming emails and triage them, and she can handle some of them on her own. and then some of them she'll send to me. It's really not necessary unless you guys have a team. It's you know, a monthly subscription that, before this I was just using Gmail and I was very happy with it. But as you know, we get more and more messages every day as time goes on, then I needed some help. So Front has been very useful for that. Anyways, those are the apps that I use. I hope you guys found that helpful. Much love, and I'll see you guys in that next one.